medical officers in the public service from engaging in private practice for personal gains. The House should note that by virtue of Section 1, Part 1, Fifth Schedule to the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, 1999, a public officer shall not put himself in a position where his personal interest conflicts with his duties and responsibilities. Also note that by virtue of Section 2B, Part 1, Fifth Schedule to the Constitution, public officer shall not, except where he is not employed on full-time basis, engage or participate in the management or running of any private business, profession, or trade except engaging in farming. Also aware that these constitutional provisions are reinforced by Rule 004428 and 04429 of the Public Service, revised as of January 2000, which equally prohibits a public officer from engaging in private practice for personal gains. Also aware that by virtue of Section 18, Subsection
2, order, honorable colleagues, order.
Part 1, Fifth Schedule to the Constitution, contravention of any of the provisions of the Code of Conduct for public officers by any officer in the public service attracts punishment, which includes vacation of office, disqualification from holding any public office for a period not exceeding 10 years, seizure and forfeiture to the state of any property acquired in abuse or corruption of office. Wonders why, in spite of the clear wordings of the Constitution and the public service rules prohibiting public officers from engaging or participating in private practice, some medical officers, particularly those working in public hospitals, apparently with the tacit acquiescence of the Nigerian Medical Association and the Medical and Dental Council of Nigeria, engage in private practice with impunity for their personal gains and to the detriment of the patients and the general public. Worried that this unethical and unpatriotic practice by some medical officers is grossly undermining the quality of services being rendered by public hospitals, thereby leading in some cases to untimely death of patients and sufferings of people of inestimable proportion. Also worried that this practice is gradually turning our public hospitals to mere referral centers in favor of private hospitals owned by the medical officers in this public service. Therefore, resolves to, one, call for a stop to the trend of medical officers in the public service engaged in private practice for personal gains, and two, mandate the committees on healthcare services and health institutions to liaise with the Federal Ministry of Health, the Nigerian Medical and Dental Council of Nigeria, the Nigerian Medical Association, the Code of Conduct Bureau, the Federal Civil Service Commission, and other relevant agencies with the view to ensuring the stoppage of this practice in accordance with the laws of the nation. Honorable Speaker, honorable colleagues, I move.
Seconder, Honorable Nasru Ali Ahmed.
Thank you very much.